Hello everyone, welcome to Liberable. This is Yasin. How's it, bro?
I'm right, myself.
Lovely stuff, man. Yasin is the owner of Maya Auto here in Fort Ricker Road. What's so awesome is Yasin actually got involved with Liberable, and what we're going to do is we're going to feature a couple of their vehicles here on Liberable. And what's cool about it is you guys get to get an in-depth perspective of what Maya Auto is like, what the customer service is like, and what they actually do over here. I'm super excited for this. It's one of the first times Liberable does something like this, and I'm super honored that Yasin is giving me the opportunity to do this. You probably know him from his M4, BMW M4. I'm gonna put a snippet in of his car over here. So yeah, you can see it's a bit of a car. But let me show you what we are going to be doing. This is the Range or Land Rover SD V6. I'm going to be taking this car around certain places in Cape Town, and I'm going to be showing you guys what this car is like. I'm also going to be showing you guys some of the inventory here at Maya Auto. What we're going to do is, basically the format of this is, this Range Rover or Land Rover is going to take me to certain places in Cape Town where we will be doing features and things like that. So thank you so much to Yasin for actually powering Liberable for the next couple of days. Yasin, take me for a walk and show me some of the stuff you got here, man.
Where do you want to start?
Let's see, because Maya Auto is not only normal cars, they got some pretty freaking intense stuff here, which a lot of you actually
don't.
Okay, cool. So here you can see is a C63S.
That's a 2018 C63S.
Yes, see.
That's brand new. We bought it from Mercedes. Mm-hmm. My brother sitting in the car one day. Dad asked us, senior, what car you want to buy? We like, nah, he says, this ICC. I said, no, man. We have BMW, we have everything. We want a Mercedes and we want a C63S. You want it in black. Black. Tinted windows, but everything black.
Nice.
Basically a gangster car.
Nice. Okay, cool. What else we got here?
And my sister has a 7R.
Nice.
It's a 2014 7R. She's also a speed freak like most of us are here. So I have to get the clip of this. She has a car 2 weeks. Okay, break this.
Enid's chops already.
That's my sister.
So the speed is in the blood, you say?
Yeah, speed is in the blood. This is obviously mine. That's the 2015 M4. It's just been fitted with the M-Performance exhaust.
Nice stuff.
From BMW. If you go around, you look at the back, it says on the box.
Nice stuff, man. And these cars have that nice raspy sound. Look at that. Yes, see. Nice.
It's an option not many people go for because of the hot BMW charging at the moment.
Oh, it's pretty expensive.
Yeah, you can say that would be expensive. You can buy a car for that money.
Flipping.
You can buy a car for that money. As you'll see over here, this is some of the luxury vehicles. If you're talking about luxury, we're talking about Mercedes, the GTI, the 12-7, we have the for the people. It's all common vehicles.
Yeah, no, that people obviously buy.
Every common guy can afford it. They just don't know they can afford it. Until you tell them, listen, your finance is beautiful. And look at the big eyes.
That's nice.
And as you go deeper onto the showroom, you get more of the common cars. Like you're talking about the Polos, the Vivos, the E90s, the ones that are priced a little bit cheaper. So those vehicles you sell on a daily. Somebody would come in at about 9 o'clock. By 12 o'clock, they'll be gone with the car.
Yo!
We'll be done because the way we operate, with two FNIs. The salespeople at the back, they do an application, they give it to them, they approve it. It takes you 2 hours to finish the application.
Wow.
He's actually climbing on the floor. He walked in right off the mosque. Before 5 o'clock, he was gone with his car.
So you guys are pretty efficient in that sense as well.
Yeah, it's the only way you're going to make money in this.
Exactly. Anyway, guys, I hope you enjoyed this video further, and thank you again so much to Yasin and Maya Auto for actually giving me this opportunity. Gentlemen, welcome to Wednesday. This is 2 days after I picked up the Land Rover Disco 4. I'm in love, I have to admit. It took me by surprise. Like, I've heard about these things, they are good. I've also heard they are extremely unreliable. But when you drive it, you understand why people love this thing. I want one as a daily. And then I want my, obviously, a fast car. Sorry for the light's really bad. But I mean, look at it. couple of things cool about it. We obviously have keyless entry. Thanks again so much to Maya Auto for the opportunity. You touch the door handle, car goes open, you unlock. What's so cool about this car is, I'm going to try focusing for you guys accordingly. Say for example, you were to start the car, right? Check this little gear lever in the center. It's so cute, or this rotation knob. Look at that! That's so cool! And also what's cool is the fact that we have air suspension here. So you can literally raise and lower this car depending on how you want it. It's so cool. Let me just turn off quickly here. So yes guys, look at this comfort. If the camera just get itself together. I mean, look at this. Look at the roof. Just glass. Let me not confuse you around here. The Meridian surround sound system in this car sounds fantastic. And here we get onto the boot, and the part I like the most of here, sorry I'm walking so wobbly, I'm just really, the gym was a bit hectic. You literally lower this down, split folding tailgate. So this literally means you can sit here and have a braai with your braai stuff, and we have 7 seats as well. So Jared and I will be doing the road test shortly, and you guys will basically see what we think about the driving experience. But I can really tell you, it's wonderful, it's magical, this thing.
Smart, and he didn't press record, and this is our third time redoing.
A third time,
literally the third time.
Guys, so we've had this Land Rover Discovery 4 for the last 4 days, and to put it in one word, stunning. I absolutely loved it. It took me by surprise because I've never driven the Land Rover Discos yet. I've only driven the Range Rover equivalent of them, and yeah, the way this thing covers ground. I mean, I had to come to him like for the last couple of days because we were filming other vehicles.
Hey, that's my house.
Thank you so much to Maya Auto for actually providing this Land Rover for us in order to get Liberable and power Liberable for this week. Thank you so much to Yassin Abdurrahman. I'll link everything down in the description box below, as I've said at the opening of this video. So yeah, Jared, tell me something. What's the specifications of this Land Rover?
So this Land Rover Discovery HSE TDV6 sounds so fancy and futuristic. So it's a V6, a 3-liter V6 diesel motor, pushing out 180 kilowatt and 600 newton meters of torque. So the various ranges of the Discovery 4 and all the other models that have 3 liters, they actually start from 155 kilowatt, okay, and go up to 188 kilowatt. This one specifically is 180. I'm not too sure what they change. Maybe it's just because it's a bit of a newer model. This car's got all the specifications. Like, it's got all the upgrades. Sound system is insane. Like Nia says, big car, big sound.
Yeah, the audio is actually done by Meridian, and it's flopping well. Dolby Pro Logic.
Like early on, Nia was really playing some music on our way home from gym, and I'm like, yo, he's like blasting this music, and I check, he's not even at halfway on the volume knob yet. I'm like, yes.
Jared, tell me quickly, what is the torque output here? Because I think that's a figure that a lot of people want to know.
680 meters of torque.
What?
It's.
So you tell me this thing can bench more than you.
Literally.
And I thought you eat my nuts and bolts of breakfast.
Definitely not.
So yeah guys, we've really enjoyed ourselves with this car for the last few days. The question is, would I buy a Land Rover slash Range Rover product?
Yes, probably, because you always call it the disco and it's got 3 sunroofs. This is a disco car. Got mad sound system
and nice
some sunroofs for the street light down in.
So yeah guys, technically I've been deceived, because these things are shocking.
Got pulls.
Reliability. Yeah, you, I mean.
Yeah, it goes. Oh, this is in driver, this has got sport.
Yeah.
It's got this all terrain stuff where rock climbing, it's got sand, some like snow mode.
But Jared, reliability, man. That's the problem.
Every second corner you turn, there's one standing on the side of the road.
Look, the thing with Yassin is, he's got, obviously this vehicle is under motor plan. So if you're buying a Land Rover slash Range Rover new,
you're not gonna have any issues for 120.
I mean,
the pool just goes. This is in normal drive
60,
mode.
70, quick, yeah. Quick.
Quick, quick. Speed limit.
It was speed limit.
Don't worry, it was
we always do 120 and 60 on Lotterie Ball, no? Yeah. Just tell me, what's your initial impressions? Like, what do you think? Like as a young youngster, like, is this something that you think is cool?
It is, yes.
It's cool, though.
Because there's three sunroofs to hang out of. You'd have two out of each one.
Sort of fighting with my arm.
This is one of those cars that, like, you can actually make one of those videos with, like, you know, guys in mankinis washing the car, you know. But otherwise, I really like it. This is like a real car to go to, like, Bloberg, to go to eat on the bay, go surfing. There's so much space at the back.
Let me grab the Canon quickly. And then I'm gonna switch to this view for you guys. Yes, guys, so we thoroughly...
No! That's not focused, is it?
Yeah, it's focused. You're not in focus. I'm in focus.
Yeah, I'm not that cool to be.
Yeah, you're not so important. Guys, so while he's busy doing the driving, let me just show you some of the stuff here in the center. We have that typical air suspension thing I showed you guys, the buttons. We have this lovely rotation knob I showed you guys in the opening of the video. A touchscreen thing, not very high def, but it does the trick. And yeah.
The rear view camera is not too great either. Mm-mm. It's very low definition. And you got all these little modes,
yeah? Yeah, actually, let me show you guys the camera quickly, because this camera is damn interesting. So, I hope you guys can see what's going on. So if you hit the camera button, you can actually see like a little, like your pigeon with your eyes on the side. You can see a curb view. Look at that. So you can see if you're going to curb the car, you can get a trailer view. So you can see what's attached to the trailer. You can get a junction view. So now you can see if this car's coming before you can get to a junction. So, pretty interesting stuff going on here.
Pretty sassy, I can say.
Definitely. Guys, thank you so much for watching this video. We want to give Yasin Abdurrahman from Maya Auto such a big thank you. This will not be the last long-term feature we do for him. There will be a lot more coming in the background. And I think it's pretty awesome that we get to live with these vehicles and give you guys an honest opinion on what the car is like to live with. I mean, like I said, we've been doing about 12 liters per 100 kilometers, still about 10 on the daily. Guys, thank you so much for watching this video. Don't forget to hit that thumbs up, subscribe, share with friends and family, and check out some other content by Lovable.
Be free, be here.
Liberable out.